into the next session very quickly because that's been on a wait for long. Decoding the phenomenal rise of Punjabi music.
Wow.
Yeah. बहुत कुछ आने वाला है तो लेट्स गेट स्ट्रेट इनटू द मॉडरेटर्स एंड स्पीकर्स प्लीज वेलकम यर अगेन एमडी एंड प्रेसिडेंट पीडीसी नेटवर्क मिस्टर रविंद्र नारायण अलोंग विद हरमीत सिंह फ्रॉम मीट ब्रोस म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर एंड डुओ अलोंग विद करण ग्रोवर डायरेक्टर म्यूजिक पार्टनरशिप फॉर इमर्जिंग मार्केट्स डॉल्बी लैब्स अलोंग विद द सिंगर एंड कंपोजर शिवानी कश्यप एंड मेंटरिंग दिस सेशन इज गोइंग टू बी द वन एंड ओनली मिहिर जोशी सिंगर एंड होस्ट एंड अ क्रिएटर of the MJ show. So all to you, and I can't wait for this one to be started. Hi Mihir, over to you.
Hi, good to be here. Happy World Music Day to everybody. Mr. Narayan, good to see you. Hi Manmeet, kaise ho? Are Manmeet nahi, Harmeet baitha hai yahan pe. Where's Manmeet? Akele hi ho aaj?
Ha bhai, एक म्यान में दो तलवारें कभी कभी नहीं भी
चलती हैं। Well, good to see you here, my friend. And we're waiting for Shivani to join us as well. I think once she joins in, we will get this. Is she here? Forgive me if I can't wait. Has Shivani joined us? Let's get her on and then let's begin it properly. Mithun, can you see if Shivani has reached?
Hello.
Oh, yeah. I can hear her, but I can't see her. Shivani, kahan pe ho? Arre, there you are. Thank you, Mithun, for bringing us here together. And let's kick off this show. So before we begin, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Music Inc. 4.0. This is a session where we're going to find out about the incredible rise of Punjabi music. I can't even call it rise right now. I think it's right at the top. So the rise would have been like if we had this conversation about 10 years ago. But right now, Punjabi music is not just kicking ass in India, but all across the world. And there's nobody better than Mr. Narayan to speak about that because he heads the biggest Punjabi music and entertainment network in the country. We've got my dear friend Harmeet, a part of the Meet Bros, making hit songs for Bollywood and beyond for so many years. And my very dear friend Shivani Kashyap, we go way, way back, all the way from Ho Gayi Hai Mohabbat to her latest song, Jogia. She's got it going on. And coincidentally, Jogia, her latest song, is a Punjabi song. Mr. Narayan and Harmeet, before we begin, I want to start off with Shivani because unfortunately Shivani had a prior commitment. Hamara jo session hai kafi late shuru hua hai. So let me start off with Shivani and then we will go deeper into Harmeet's music, into the business of Punjabi music as well. So Shivani, welcome. Firstly, congratulations on your new single. It is doing so well. Lots of love that you've got. I've been seeing the reels coming up on Instagram. I've been seeing so many people trying to cover your song. So how does it feel? I know you've been making music for a long time, but how does it feel to see the success of Jogia?
Thank you, Mihir. And thank you for this question. And, you know, I kind of was very nervous before I actually decided to take a plunge and do this song. And this Jogia is quite... Because before this, whatever Punjabi songs that I've done are now kind of modernized and poppy and, you know, very sort of colloquial. But this one is really Theth Punjabi. And I really loved the whole process of making the song. It was wonderful, even shooting the video, etc. It was a lovely... And, you know, we had to release the song with a big bang in a huge press conference because we'd got a wonderful actor, Dheeraj Dhupar, who's very well television scenario. Mm-hmm. And lo and behold, there was the lockdown which happened suddenly. And so we had to do everything virtually. So yeah. I was like, okay, now this is going to be the true test of the song, you know, because up your hair, sab kuch, you know, people will be watching my song on their gadgets or whatever.
Okay.
So organically, we crossed 2 million views.
That's
and
amazing.
I'm very, very happy about that.
That's phenomenal.
And the main, thank you. The other thing is that the reels, so every day there are people making reels on the song. So that is the biggest, hugest compliment.
Yeah.
I think the song really helped me to connect back the roots, which is Punjab. I am a Punjabi myself. And
right.
I was like wondering, yaar, main itne saalon se I've been doing songs. Why didn't I dabble with Punjabi before? So
correct.
I right after this song, Meera, I've just recorded a song called Luck Shake, which features Govinda's daughter, Tina Ahuja, which is on the verge of release. It's another Punjabi song. So here on starts my music. So I'm really thrilled, actually.
So I see Mr. Narayan smiling very happily because I'm sure he's excited about the fact that there's more Punjabi music coming from you, which I'm sure he will help get across to the rest of the world through his amazing network. But Shivani, I know you're in a hurry, but before you leave, I have to ask you to sing a little bit of your song. We can't let you go without performing a little bit, especially considering aaj World Music Day. So thoda to performance hota hi hai.
They don't want to.
Is somebody else talking around here? I can't make out. There was some sound somewhere. Sorry, Shivani, go ahead, please. Yeah.
So, Meher, also, I'd like to reiterate that in 2003, when I started my career as a Bollywood singer composer, right. With the song Sajna Abhi Ja, to wo usme bhi thodi si Punjabi ki hint tha.
Correct.
Nahi lagda. I just tried to do it. Wo bhi kafi hit hua tha wo gana because I don't know, was it because of that Nahi Lagda Tere Bina? Because, you know, somewhere, I think the Punjabi language has a mass appeal.
Correct.
The bounce, it has the catchiness and the peppiness. So anyway, I'll just sing a few lines of Jogya. And
please,
really happy to be a part of this panel. And Ravindarji, thank you so much. You played Jogya on your channel so heavily, so amazingly. big thank you for that. Thank you so much.
Lovely.
Okay, here we go. Jogya ve mundira valiya, main dil tere na halaliya. जोगिया हाय जोगिया कड़के ना जावी दिलो छड़के ना जावी वे कड़के ना जावी दिलो छड़के ना जावी तैनू दिल दे विच वसा लिया जोगिया हाय.
Yeah, thank you so much, Shivani. I want to wish you bolo.
So tell you, hi, happy World Music Day to see you. Yeah. I have a full song for Harmeet, which is yet to be released. It's a song called Ishq Awala. That too is in Punjabi.
Kya
it's
baat hai.
Beautiful. So once it comes out, I'm sure it's going to really rock it. It's a beautiful composition by the Meet Bros.
Lovely. So coincidentally, Shibani, when Jogya released, you came on the MJ show, you spoke about it. Abhi Harmeet bhi yahan pe hai, to tum dono ka jab gana saath mein release hoga, please come back. We'll talk a little bit more about it. Shibani, thank you so much for joining us today. I'm glad you could wait around and perform a little bit. Mr. Narayan, you had something to say to Shibani. Boliye, sir.
It is so glad to see Shivani making such great music. I remember late 90s and early 2000s when she would just troop into her Green Park office with a guitar and she anchored a show called Rhythmics Show, which aired on ATN at that time.
Kya baat.
And it's from that onward that I followed her career. She's done amazing work and she continues to do it.
Yep.
The biggest thing in music industry is people come, people do good things and they disappear or they fade away.
Correct.
She's been one artist who's been very consistent.
Oh, 100%.
Creating good music.
100%, sir.
I would like to add to that, if there was an award for the most persistent artist in the country, I think I would go to Shivani.
Yeah.
You made my day, Hari. Harmeet, you made my day. Ravindarji, you made my day. And of course, Meher, you've always been a supporter and a friend. But thank you so much. And Hari, I can't wait for our song to release. Because that is going to be a beautiful one. I'm very, such a beautiful composition.
We're destined to give the industry something together because my first song was Jogi Singh Barnala Singh in way back in 1999. So it was a Punjabi song and today you've come up with Jogia. Your husband is my best friend. We have a way to go and we'll rock the Punjabi industry even more.
Wow, that's fantastic. Lovely, Shivani. Take care of yourself. Happy World Music Day to you. We'll see you soon. Bye. So Shivani had to leave us for now, but we now are with Harmeet and with Mr. Narayan. So Mr. Narayan, before I know we've kept you waiting for a while, you had a chance to just speak a little bit with Shivani, but I got to ask Harmeet, you've been making Punjabi music outside of Bollywood and within Bollywood for a very, very long time. So before we ask Mr. Narayan about the growth that he has seen in that industry, tell me how important has Punjabi music been for you? I mean, it goes back to your roots, but how important has it been for you from a creative perspective?
So I would like to say in one form that it's not just about how it's important to me. The way it's shaped up is it's become Punjabi music is become inevitably present everywhere. I mean, you cannot live, even if you don't like it, you'll have to hear it. It's become compulsory by the universe.
Absolutely.
Go dance, party, office, they will be somewhere in the background. Punjabi music is in the air, basically. I think we should put it like that. So when Punjabi music is in the air, plus I'm a Punjabi, plus I'm a musician, so it runs in my blood, basically. Okay. And I think why it has become like this, why is it so important is because at the end of the day, the history plays the most important. You see, everything, whether it's, for example, a very basic understanding of the whole world is that Gujarat is known for diamonds and textile. Punjab was known for the agriculture, and the Sikh community was born as a warrior. Okay, when they were born as warriors, there was so much of hard work in farming and in wars. The Punjabi community turned out to be a very tough community, and with that toughness and tough times came out beautiful. The pain turned out to be into a beautiful melodies and folk music.
Lovely. Because when
there were wars and people were in pain, what comes out? You need to take out the stress through music.
Correct.
And the folk, was born. The Punjabi folk is so rich, and that is running in our blood. So
beautiful.
When the internet came in the last 10 years, when YouTube and all this internet came in, that hidden gem came out in the open. And the language itself, and it's like a God gift. That language is also, like Shivani said, very peppy and bouncy. So with that phonetics and that folk music combined together on internet became viral. See, agar ek banda, jaise mera baby doll song hai, and if somebody said that, usi cheez ko main agar Hindi mein bolta, ki baby doll main hoon, badi sundar sone ki hoon. Aur wohi chota baby doll main sone di. There is a bounce in that. So I think inevitably becomes important for us, and you cannot live without Punjabi.
Mr. Narayan, I'm going to ask you about this. I've been speaking about this for many years, from my radio days to now, and I believe that Indian music is capable of reaching out to the rest of the world. Now, we've seen from the last maybe two decades how Spanish music has taken over the world. We've seen in the last 5 to 6 years how Korean pop and Korean music is something that people are embracing or even Italian songs, some of them, or whatever. But my point is, in India, there are kids who are having a great time dancing on Spanish songs and K-pop songs and whatnot. And I've always believed that we've got music which is capable of transcending the language barrier, the spatial barrier, going to other countries. We should be able to have a Korean kid somewhere sitting and dancing on baby doll or on some other Punjabi songs. And I think what was important was to give it that vehicle where you realize that this is not local, it is global. I'm actually kind of quoting you because I was seeing your beautiful TEDx talk, and I love what you said, that there are Punjabis and potatoes everywhere, and we need to get the Punjabis even more popular than potatoes. And I think you've successfully done that with PTC. So tell me a little bit about the journey of PTC, about how you realized, at the very start that this is not just a local phenomenon. It's not something ki bhai ye sirf Punjab ke liye karna hai ya sirf, north of India ke liye karna hai, but you can take this music to the rest of the world.
See, I would like to just correct you that Spanish music or Italian music has taken over the world. It's not so. They come in burst.
Correct.
We'll have a Bella Ciao once in a blue moon, which will capture the world.
Correct.
But Punjabi music has captivated and captured the world since the 80s.
Absolutely.
Dhamis and Awaz and Hira groups who actually revolutionized Punjabi music when they went to UK and created a whole club circuit where there was Punjabi music being performed in clubs and parties and all over the world. So that for me was phase one, where Punjabi pop, actually Sas Kutni and Pyar Di Awaz and all those songs, Shakti, all these groups became phenomena. And they introduced the West to Punjabi music.
Mm-hmm.
But the earliest recorded evidence of Punjabi music's greatness has been by the historians who came with Alexander. And they have written that this is an amazing land.
Wow.
Quote them, they say, ਇੱਧਰ ਦੇ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਆਪਣੇ ਤੇ ਹੱਸਣਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ, ਆਪਣੇ ਤੇ ਰੋਣਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ, ਤੇ ਹਰ ਚੀਜ਼ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ, ਹਰ ਓਕੇਜ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਗਾਣਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ। ਇਹ ਉਦਾਸ, if they are sad, there's a song coming out of them. They're
Lovely.
Happy, there's a song coming out of them. Their festivals, their occasions, birth, death, everything is related to music. And that's true for the Indian music per se. There is a song for everything you have. And Punjabi music, basically why it conquered the world is because of the passion. Punjab has been the land of passion. without passion, there is no creation. So that's why this is all also the seat of all wisdom. The ancient epics, or the Granths, the most ancient piece of literature, which is composed in jo rachayein kehte hain, couplets kehte hain, musically, is Rig Veda. The Gayatri Mantra written in Rig Veda, still being enchanted by, narrated by us every day, written in Punjab. Rig Veda was written in Punjab. Ramayana, Mahabharata, all these verses, epics created in Punjab. It's been the seat of wisdom, and there is music ingrained in it. The youngest religion in the world, Sikhism. The entire Guru Granth Sahib was composed by the great gurus with specific ragas, specific times, and everything dotted and specified how to sing it, when to sing it, and everything is being sung. Gurbani, that's the basis of our music. The entire PTC network's basis is Gurbani. We started the telecast in 98. It has continued uninterrupted through various channels when we started it. And on PTC for the last 12 years, 13 years now. That's music. And after that UK-based musicians era, came the era of Gurdas Mann. Before them, there was Surinder Kaur, Asa Singh Mastana, and all those, but they were confined only to live shows.
Correct.
Or once in a blue moon record that would come on HMV someday on the radio. But even that was popular all across. Even in Bollywood, it was popular. Jagte Raho was the film of Raj Kapoor, which had Punjabi tappe boliyan in it. Scene, he's dressed up as a Sikh. That's the earliest I recount of a Punjabi music happening
in the mainstream.
In Bollywood.
Correct.
And after that came the era of Gurdas Mann. Then the likes of Daler Mehndi, Jassies, they really took it international. It went international in a big way. Then the artists who were based in Birmingham, who were in Toronto, who were in Vancouver, it became an industry. And it all started with the Big Bang when in 98 we started Punjabi World and then converted into ETC Punjabi. That's when the actual boom came. I mean, I still remember the artists. I would not like to name them now. They would come to us with money in bags. Please take this money. Make a music video for us. Make us record our song. Because before HMV ne record kar diya, toh ho gaya. Otherwise, who would release an album? Who would record them? Who would show them on television? Doordarshan would once in a blue moon will show something. Dil Ka Mamla will become a hit once it is performed in a New Year Eve concert.
Correct. But
after that, once the channel came into being, the ETC and then PTC, there was no stopping. Now we have three music channels. We have an audio label. We record song. I think we're the only television network which records original music. We have more than 500 recordings we have done in the last 2.5 years.
That's amazing.
Punjabi songs. And we continue to create music. This year, we took an oath. We made a policy that this year we will record at least 400 songs and we will not charge a penny to any singer.
That's any amazing.
Singer, they can record, they can release a track. We will record them. We will make their music video. We'll put it on air. We'll put it on our label. We'll put it on our digital. We have 97 Facebook pages, 6 Twitter handles, 7 websites across the world. We're going to push it. See, this is the least we can do. For decades, channels like us have made money out of music, out of these artists. Today, we are in a situation due to pandemic. Every artist, many are proud. They would not say so that they have suffered. Every artist is suffering. For every artist, this has been a question of survival. Because how does artist survive? Singers survive, musicians survive. By live
performances.
Shows.
Yep.
Nobody makes money just by releasing a song on YouTube or putting it on a streaming platform or cutting an album. They don't make money by that.
Correct.
It's a myth that these PPL, IPRS, they will look after you, they will take care of you. I've seen Idu Sharif dying in penury and NGOs and us contributing for his treatment. So nothing comes to them. All all money is made by companies.
Live performances,
companies who make money out of the artist.
Correct.
The artist has only one source, live shows.
Correct, that's right.
He gets publicity, he gets shows. And Punjabi artists have been very enterprising. They were always busy. Every weekend they would be performing somewhere or other on the globe. Correct. They would have club performances, concerts, private concerts, marriage shows, birthdays, somewhere or the other. The pandemic meant for 1.5 years, no shows. No shows mean no money. No money means you can't survive. What do you
That's
do?
That's true. That is
That's
true.
When we made a decision, no artist which comes to us to be charged any penny, we will record them.
That's amazing.
Platform. The platform must become the medium for their survival now. If they're good, whenever the pandemic goes away, whenever the show's open, they will get work. But they should not be that they can't record, they don't have that money, so they'll go out of sight, out of mind, and the industry should come to a standstill. It should not be. We've continued with e-concerts, recording. We merged technology with television, and we collaborated with artists where the tabla player was in Ludhiana, the vocalist was in Delhi, the guitar player was in Jalandhar, and we collaborated with them to online put them together in an e-concert. And the technology is there to help you. Bluetooth mics, sync audios, and a lot of things we employed so that concerts remain going on, audience gets new music, artists get to perform, get to remain in the groove, because honestly, I've seen a few artists selling vegetables today.
That's true. I mean, it has been a difficult time, sir. And I think it's an incredible thing that you are doing for the music community by giving them an opportunity. And this is how it was back in the day before everything was so easily doable by yourself. Back in the day, a record label, which is what you also are now, would search for good talent, take that talent on and create that talent's music. And it's great to see that there is at least one entity which is going the old school record label route and saying that, hey, if you've got the talent, we will give you the platform, we will make your music and we will put it out there. So, you know, congratulations, sir, on such an amazing, you know, decision that you have taken. And I think a lot of artists in our country will be extremely grateful to you for that. Harmeet, I got to ask you about something that Ms. Narayan just spoke right now, which is, you know, this has been a difficult time. Sabke liye kaafi mushkil raha hai. I mean, this 1 year and whatever, 3-4 months that we've had to pretty much be locked down. Theek hai, beech mein though, maybe there were a few months that things kind of opened up. How has it been for you from an artist perspective? You know, I know the Meat Brothers were performing live all across the world. You have these incredible live concerts where people enjoy your music in the most real way possible, where, you know, they're right in front of you, they're dancing and singing along, because you've got all these hits that people love to sing along with you on. So, abhi ye pichle ek ded saal se ghar pe, you know, ghar pe ya, you know, studio mein kaam kar rahe ho maybe, but you've not had a chance to go all out the way you could have done, say, before a year and a half ago. How has this time been for you, and what have you been doing? What is the musical creativity that has been happening to you? I'm assuming that has not stopped.
See, before I get into that lane, I would like to acknowledge and compliment Mr. Gavindra for taking such a good initiative on. And it is so important as an artist, and you know that we have a music label called Epic Music, which started about 2 years ago. It's doing decently well. And I've understood the last 3 years, I've understood the business pretty much. And it is really important that people like Rabindra Ji, who are sitting on top and who achieved in so many years, have achieved a great height of success. It's a payback time for sure. And we need to give credit and congratulate people like Rabindra Narayan Ji, who are actually, you know, thinking and working towards it. And when they say the law of attraction and manifestation is that when you actually try, then only things happen, right? So it's not easy to recover the kind of money he's planning to invest in the artist. But I truly believe as a spiritual being that the intention achhu insan ki aur insan genuinely karna chahta ho, you know, his base was very clear ki pandemic mein artist ke paas shows nahi the, to, you know, bahut difficulties thi. It could be khane ke liye bhi paise nahi ho ya koi ya jeene ke liye bhi paise na ho. To ye emotion hi hota hai, jaise unhone bola ki Punjabi music jo grow kara hai passion se, ek community hai. एक हम जैसे मैंने बोला कि हिस्ट्री प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल, यू नो, वी आर ऑल फार्मर्स, वी आर ऑल पैशनेट पीपल, देयर इज अ देयर वाज सो मच ऑफ एनर्जी इन पंजाबीज. इफ यू सी द एक्चुअली द कमर्शियल, लाइक ही टोल्ड यू द हिस्ट्री ऑफ पंजाबी, हाउ इट ग्रू इन द इंडस्ट्री. बट आई रिमेम्बर दलेर मेहंदी वाज द बोलो तारारा वाज द कमर्शियल एंगल व्हिच इट चेंज द डायनामिक्स ऑफ द कंट्री. So,
absolutely.
Punjabi market, as in, as Punjab as a market was growing very well inside, within the Punjab. they were Gurdas Manji and there were many legends to name. But when it came to Bollywood, Bolo Tarara and Nana Nana Nare or Dardi Rab Rab changed the game. And then obviously many other punch, like now the Honey Singh came and he brought in rap in Punjabi, Badshah, Guru Randhawa, you know, Neha Kakkar's.
Bohemia.
So I think it's also destiny that all of a sudden, God like Yashraj and Dharma brought in Punjabi music in that. So when everybody, all the Punjabis came up together with their passion, people realized that Punjabi music is very rich. And it actually gave industry a great amount of music to dance on and party. Because every wedding, every festival, every celebration in life, is the pandemic mein sari depression hai, wo kaise jayegi? Wo party se jayegi ya music se jayegi ya kisi aisi cheez se jayegi jisme energy hai. Okay, I think khana to aap kha lete ho, lekin non-stop music chal sakta aapke background. That is the Punjabi music which gives you that bounce, beat, dance, bhangra, you know, the language. It's again another very big reason, because today the topic is that how did Punjabi music make a difference? So I want to focus on that part, which might help a lot of musicians and the entrepreneurial music entrepreneurs to understand that as not only as an entrepreneur, as a creative guy, ki what really helps. The fact that Punjabi language is very similar to Hindi language. If you speak Tamil or Kannada, you won't understand what they are singing in the song. But Dil Lagi Kudi Gujarat Ki is very similar to Hindi. Dil Lagi Kudi Gujarat Ki.
Correct.
So there are some God gifts in Punjabi language, which makes it very bouncy, peppy, simple to understand. And I'm very glad that, the summit today, the Anurag Batra's team and everyone has picked up this topic, because it's important for people to realize that agar ek Punjabi language or Punjabi music industry gifted hai, Ravindra ji, this is for you. Hum logo ko realize karna bahut zaruri hai ki agar Lata ji ya Kishore ji, jinhone sikha bhi nahi tha, but wo gift the to gifted the, us pe koi question mark nahi ho sakta. Agar hum ye bhoolne jaye ki kyun itna bada ho gaya Punjabi music, bhai waise to hum log main bahut I went into my meditation and I also start thinking, kahan se aaya Punjabi music, itna bada kyun ho gaya? I realized it was the pain which was during the Sikh regiment, jab humare bane the, Punjabis were warriors. To jo pain aur jo ek emotions the humare hum logo ke, agriculture was the what do you say, economy of our country for hundreds of years. तो जिस चीज पे इतना मेहनत लगती थी तो साथ में उनको एंटरटेनमेंट लोड़ी में आग लगा के गाने गा रहे हैं, भांगड़ा कर रहे हैं, टप्पे कर रहे हैं, चिमटे बजा रहे हैं, ढोल बजा रहे हैं, तुम्बी बजा रहे हैं. तो वो सब चीजों से एक नेचुरल एवोल्यूशन ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटी जैसे होता है, एवोल्यूशन ऑफ पंजाबी म्यूजिक हुआ. तो द कंक्लूजन आई एम ट्राइंग टू मेक इज कि एक गिफ्ट मिला है हमारी इंडियन म्यूजिक इंडस्ट्री को पंजाबी म्यूजिक का. हमारे पास बड़े अच्छे लोग हैं, रविंद्र जी जैसे, और सिंगर्स हैं इतने सारे, आजकल सारे पंजाबी सिंगर्स पूरी जान लगा रहे हैं. इट्स बिकम बिगर देन इवन समहाउ बॉलीवुड म्यूजिक, वी ऑल नो दैट, राइट?
या
इट्स गिवन इन सो मेनी आर्टिकल्स इन इकोनॉमिक टाइम्स एंड हियर एंड देयर. सो वी गॉट टू गिव दैट अवार्ड, दैट क्रेडिट टू पंजाबी म्यूजिक, दैट इट्स अ गॉड गिफ्ट. इट हैपेंड ऑर्गेनिकली फ्रॉम द सॉइल ऑफ पंजाब. And I think we should all actually, from here, this World Music Day, we should actually make a organization or a committee to make sure that this becomes worldwide. Like jaise tha wo gana aaya tha, Mundiya to Bach ke Rami, worldwide
hit hua
tha.
Correct.
I Lab Jandua ke saath maine 3-4 gaane record kare the. Last unka last gana by the way was with me in Akshay Kumar mein tha. I remember he used to tell me यार कि ये global hit है. मैं जब भी उनसे पूछा था आपका गाना hit है, कहता नहीं सर ये गाना hit नहीं, ये global hit है. अमेरिका में भी जब मैं 2003 में गया था,
correct,
अंग्रेज लोग इस पे नाच रहे थे सब clubs में. मैं world tour के लिए गया था सलमान खान और संजय दत्त और बिपाशा बसु के साथ, हर club में ये गाना चल रहा था. So
correct,
the fact that Punjabi music is so huge,
right.
It is like how hip hop came from, the Queens and America mein jaise aaya tha. Hum isko worldwide bada bana sakte hain agar ek community, agar hum Anurag Batra ji ko bole aur Ravindra ji ko bole ki ek community banaiye, aur uske andar hum log har quarter mein, har saal mein 4 baar uski meeting karke bol ke hum kya kar sakte hain, paisa kahan se raise kar sakte hain, gaane aur gaano ke kaise aur acche lyricists ko bula sakte hain aage. I know that YPO and EU are organizations jiski wajah se logo ke kafi economies badhti hain. To jab organizations saath mein aati hain to Punjabi music industry can become bigger than any other industry ever, because it has a God gift of sound, phonetics, passion, craziness. एक पागलपन है आप, मतलब आप जानते हो हमारे मिक्का बाजी को.
नहीं बिल्कुल हरमीत, I gotta add on to something that you just said, which I have genuinely believed for the last one decade at least. जैसे अभी आजकल if you talk to anybody in the international music scene, they say that hip hop is the biggest thing in the world. मैं believe करता हूँ कि इंडिया का अगर कोई genre is capable of being the hip hop of India, it's Punjabi music. I mean, not just from a musical perspective, but also now look at the kind of technology that is being brought into the music. I mean, what I mean by that is how good the songs are sounding. While they are rooted in folk and while they are still being sung in hardcore Punjabi, they are ready to take on hip hop music as well. Like, abhi one of the latest big hits was Brown Munde. Mr. Narayan, आपको क्या लगता है? You know, when that song came out, it was pretty much like a sensation, again like one of those global hit kind of a song which people were dancing on, making reels, making TikToks all over the world. I want to ask you specifically, in the last say 1 or 2 years, maybe 3 years, how have you seen the evolution of modern Punjabi music? I'm not talking about just the folk rooted Punjabi music, but you know, kids who are saying that, yaar, mujhko, I'm very proud of the fact that I'm Punjabi and I have my folk roots, but I'm a modern kid, I love hip hop and I want to bring my Punjabi-ness to modern music. So what do you feel about that?
See, you must understand, all Punjabis have one quality. They can adapt. They can go anywhere in the world and become one with that place. In Gayatri Mantra, we say peace to this element, peace to that element, so that we are in harmony with the elements. The right. quality in Punjabis and the people who are from Punjabis, they can adjust, they can be in harmony with any elements around them. Mm-hmm. That makes them like a fish takes to water.
Yeah.
When Gurbani says, remember God like fish remembers water. So for Punjabis, music is like such a thing. They have music in them. So wherever they are, they will adapt. They will take those elements, put it into their own music and make it sound like that and make it unique. They've been doing it with great elan and now they've actually mastered it.
That's beautiful.
And I've seen a packed house concert in Barcelona of Malkeet Singh, where the entire audience was almost all Spanish people. No, not many Punjabis of this. A packed house, all dancing to his Tutak, Tutak, Tuti and other
songs. Of course.
You know, so this is the quality in Punjabis.
That's amazing.
The new wave that you're talking about, the Brown Mondays and all those things, the trend started by Honey, Raftar, and now mastered by these newcomers.
Correct.
It is precisely that. They've taken the beat from Italy, Spain, Vancouver, from different places, different genres.
And they've adapted to it.
Made it Punjabi.
Correct. I believe we are kind of running out of time. Mithun, thank you for coming. And I have been seeing the messages. I'm on my phone, but I've been seeing the messages. Rohail, yes, we will wrap up. But before we wrap up, hey, World Music Day hai, bhai. Main tumhe bina gaaye nahi chhod sakta hu. Harmeet, थोड़ा तो कुछ हमें गा के दिखाओ. मैंने जैसे पूछा था, वी डिडंट गेट इनटू इट बिकॉज़ यू टॉक्ड अबाउट समथिंग अ लॉट मोर इम्पोर्टेंट एंड आई एम ग्लैड यू स्पोक अबाउट इट. बट हरमीत, व्हाट हैव यू बीन वर्किंग ऑन? कुछ सुनाओ, कोई पुराना गाना सुनाओ, कुछ नया सुनाओ, मगर निकलने के पहले कुछ गाना तो सुनाओ भाई.
देखो भैया, एक हमारे इंडस्ट्री का कानून है, अनरिलीज गाना नहीं गा सकते.
तो अनरिलीज मत गाओ ना, तो पुराना गाना गाओ, हिट गाना गाओ.
क्या आने वाला है ये सवाल एज एन एंकर? जबकि अच्छा, बाय द वे, आई वांट टू कॉम्प्लीमेंट यू कि तुम यार नॉन म्यूजिशियन होते हुए बड़ी खतरनाक नॉलेज है. व्हेन यू स्पोक अबाउट हिप हॉप बीइंग द बिगेस्ट जॉनर एंड हाउ पंजाबी,
भाई 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 ऐसे मत करो. पिछले 16 साल से मैं म्यूजिशियन हूँ, मैं सिंगर हूँ, मेरा इंग्लिश बैंड है, ठीक है, मैं पंजाबी में नहीं गाता हूँ, मगर ये मत बोलो कि मैं इतना भी भाई तुम्हारे स्टूडियो में आके गाना गाया है तुम्हारे लिए, कैसे भूल रहे हो यार
भाई. तुम्हारी इमेज एंकर कितनी ज्यादा स्ट्रांग है कि म्यूजिशियन वाली शर्म मेरे माइंड से निकल गया. तो
कोई बात नहीं, कोई बात नहीं,
फिर तो तुम्हें भी गाना पड़ेगा.
हाँ चलो, मैं गाता हूँ, बट पहले तुम तो सुनाओ ना.
तो मैं, मेरा पंजाबी गाना जो मैं एक्चुअली, आप लोगों ने बीबीडो चिटे तो सुना है, बट एक मेरा गाना है जिस जो बड़ा ही पंजाबी बॉलीवुड और पॉप का मिक्स था. बहुत क्रेजी पॉपुलर नहीं है, लेकिन वो मेरा पर्सनल फेवरेट है, मैं वो गा के सुनाऊंगा. एकता कपूर की एक फिल्म में था.
लवली.
उसके बाद आई विल गेट इनटू द चिटियां गलाइयां रैप एंड फिल्म.
हां, गो फॉर इट.
तेरी शर्ट दा मैं ता बटन सोनिए, बालों का तेरे में आए रैन हो गया, चांद से भी ज्यादा सोना मुखड़ा तेरा है, दिखते ही दिल ये स्लिप हो गया, मर गए यार दीवाने ओ तेरे नबर पुराने, ओ डाई हार्ड फैन तेरे हैं तू ही कदर न जाने है, ओ मर गए यार दीवाने ओ तेरे लवर पुराने, ओ डाई हार्ड फैन तेरे हैं तू ही कदर न जाने है, तेरे माइक दा मैं ता फैन हो गया, क्या कमाल बनना है यो मदा Angel, baby, white kalaya drives me crazy. Shiny eyes, glittery, glittery, glittery. You're the light that makes me go hazy. Chittiya kalaya, baby, oh baby, teri chittiya kalaya, baby. Chittiya kalaya, baby, oh baby, teri white kalaya, baby. Baby doll, main sone di. Oh baby doll, main sone di. Oh baby doll, main sone di. Oh baby doll, main. सोने दी।
क्या बात है, थैंक यू सो मच हरमीत, थैंक यू मिस्टर नारायण, थैंक यू एक्सचेंज फॉर मीडिया म्यूजिक इंक 4.0 has just begun. Ho bola maine, kya baat hai, ye dekho, I meant to say music inc 4.0 has begun. There's going to be a lot more happening for the rest of the day, but this was a panel where we talked about the incredible rise of Punjabi music. There we have Mr. Narayan, my brother Harmeet Singh, Shibani Kashyap was just here with us, my name is Mihir Joshi, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you Mihir, thank you Harmeet Paji, thank you Ravindra Paji again, thank you so much.